But you know, I like a lot of things. Stories with deep psychological elements usually immerse me as well. Isn't it amazing how a writer can so deliberately take advantage of your own lack of imagination to completely throw you off for... throw you for a loop? Isn't it amazing how a writer can so deliberately take advantage of your own lack of imagination to completely throw you for a loop?
Interpretiere ich jetzt zu viel in den einen Satz rein? Denn das hier ist ja ein Loop, oder?
Anyway, I've been reading a lot of horror lately. I read a horror book once. I desperately grab something I can relate to at a minimum level. At this rate, Yuri might as well be having a conversation with a rock. I expect that coming from you, Yuri. It suits your personality. Oh, is that so? Really, if a story makes me think or takes me to another world, then I really can't put it down. Surreal horror is often very successful at changing the way you look at the world, if only for a brief moment.
Es gibt die vierte Wand durchbrechen und es gibt mich beim Kopf nehmen und immer wieder dagegen schlagen.
I hate horror.
Oh, why is that?
Well, I just... Natsuki's eyes dart over me for a split second.
Never mind.
That's right, you usually like to write about cute things, don't you think, Natsuki?
What?
What gives you that idea? You left a piece of scrap paper behind last club meeting. It looked like you were working on a poem called Don't Say It Out Loud. And give that back.
Fine, fine. Natsuki, you write your own poems?
Ah, well, I guess sometimes. Why do you care?
I think that's impressive.
Why don't you share them sometime?
No.
Natsuki averts her eyes.
You wouldn't like them.
I'm not very confident writer yet.
I understand how Natsuki feels.
I understand. Sharing that level of writing takes more than just confidence. The truest form of writing is writing to oneself. You must be willing to open up to your readers, exposing your vulnerabilities and showing even the deepest reaches of your heart. Do you have writing experience too, Yuri? Maybe if you share some of your work, you can set an example and help Natsuki feel comfortable enough to share hers.
I guess it's the same for Yuri.
We all sit in silence for a moment.
Hey, I just got an idea.
How about this? Natsuki and Yuri look quizzically at Monika. Let's all go home and write a poem of our own. Then next time we meet, we'll all share them with each other. That way, everyone is even.
I mean, I thought it was a good idea.
Well, I think you're right, Monika. We should probably start finding activities for all of us to participate in together. I did decide to take the responsibility of vice president after all. I need to do my best to nurture the club as well as its members. Besides, now that we have a new member, it seems like a good step for us to take.
Ging das beim letzten Mal auch so schnell oder war die erste? Natürlich war die erste Unterhaltung langatmiger. Wenn einen Charakter mehr hatten, der geredet hat.
Hold on, there's still one problem.
What's that?
Now that we've reached the most important topic, I bluntly come forth with what's been on my mind the entire time. I never said I would join this club. Monika may have convinced me to stop by, but I never made any decision. I still have other clubs to look at and, I lose my train of thought. All three girls stare at me with dejected eyes. But... I'm sorry, I thought... The girls exchange glances before Monika turns back to me.
I guess I need to tell you the truth, Mikey.
The thing is... We don't have enough members yet to form an official club. We need four. And I've been trying really, really hard to find new members.
And if we don't find one more before the festival...
Oh ja, sag nein und grätsch den voll in die Parade rein und guck, was passiert. I'm defenseless against these girls.
Du pubertierender kleiner Hurensohn!
How am I supposed to make a clear-headed decision when it's like this? It would feel terrible for letting everyone down in this situation. And besides, the club itself seems pretty relaxed. So if writing poems is the price I need to pay in order to spend every day with these beautiful girls?
Right.
Okay, I've decided then. I'll join the literature club. One by one, the girls' eyes light up.
Oh my goodness, really?
Do you really mean that, Mikey?
Yeah, it could be fun, right? You really did scare me for a moment. I mean, if you're really just left after all this, I would be super pissed. Mikey, I'm so happy. We can become an official club now. Thank you so much for this, you're really amazing. I'll do everything I can to give you a great time. Ah, thanks, I guess. Okay, everyone, I think with that we can officially end today's meeting on a good note. Everyone remember tonight's assignment. Write a poem to bring to the next meeting so we can all share. Monica looks over at me once more. Mikey, I look forward to seeing how you express yourself. Where's the question? Yeah. Can I really impress the class star Monica with my mediocre writing skills? I already feel the anxiety welling up inside me. Meanwhile, the girls continue to chit-chat as Yuri cleans up the tea set. I guess I'll be on my way then. Okay, I'll see you tomorrow then. I can't wait. With that, I depart the clubroom and make my way home. Fällt mir nicht ein, dass da irgendjemand fehlt. The whole way my mind wanders back and forth between the three girls. Natsuki, Yuri, and of course Monika. Will I really be happy spending every day after school in a literature club? Perhaps I'll have the chance to grow closer to one of these girls. Alright, I'll just need to make the most of my circumstances and I'm sure good fortune will find me. And I guess that starts with writing a poem tonight. You have unlocked a special poem. Would you like to read it? Yes. Hä? Was? Da lese ich ja aus einer SCP-Akte mehr raus. Oh, fucking hell. Zumindest passiert was. Ich fände es ja schon kurios, dass ich ja jetzt alles wieder durchreden muss, lesen muss, um auf kleine Details zu achten, wenn ich ehrlich bin, aber wir hören jetzt garantiert nicht auf, deswegen. Fucking hell. Haben die schon immer so traurig ausgesehen? Komm, wir machen es diesmal anders. Hier. Anger. Was? Wieso reagierst du auf Anger? Massaker. Instabil, Destiny, Horror, Unrestrained. Wir machen das jetzt so düster wie möglich. Wir versuchen das Unending. Incapable, Melancholy, Entropy, Nightgown. Wieso? Tragedy. Raincloud, was? Warum? Inferno. Eternity. Spinning, keine Ahnung. Extrem. Agonizing. Vivid. Hoffnungslos. Okay. Kann ich das irgendwie nochmal nachgucken? Nö, offensichtlich nicht. Hi again, Mikey. Okay. Ach so, der ganze Hinweg fällt jetzt weg, weil Sayori fehlt. What the flying fuck? Glad to see you didn't run away on us. Ah, don't worry. This might be a little strange for me, but I at least keep my word. When I'm back at the Literature Club. I was the last to come in, so everyone else is already hanging out. What the fuck, Spiel? Thanks for keeping your promise, Mikey. I hope this isn't too overwhelming of a commitment for you. Making you dive headfirst into literature when you're not accustomed to us? Oh, come on, like he deserves any slack. You already had to be dragged in here by Monica. I don't know if I kept plans. Alter, komm schon. But if you don't take us seriously, then you won't see the end of it. Du bist da übrigens so ein bisschen im Vordergrund, Monika. Die Musik gerade geeiert? Natsuki finds herself stuck between saying Monika und Manga. Manga is literature. Swiftly defeated, Natsuki plops back into her seat. I'm sorry, Mikey. We'll make sure to put your comfort first, okay? Yori shoots Natsuki with a disappointed glance. Anyway, now that you're in the club and all, perhaps you might have interest in picking up a book to read? Well, I can't really say no either way. Like you said, I'm in this club now. So it only feels right for me to do something like that if you ask. Wait, I didn't mean it like that. If you don't really want to, then forget I said anything, I guess. And no, it's not that, Yori. I want to try to be a part of this club. So even if I don't read often, I'd be happy to pick up a book if you wanted me to. Are you sure? It just felt like, well, as vice president and all, but I should help you get started on something you might like. Yuri reaches into her bag and pulls out a book. Die Musik hat doch gerade geeiert. Und das ganze Bild ist doch schräg, oder? Fucking hell. Ein Paranoia kriegt gerade echt das Beste von mir. I didn't want you to feel left out, so I picked up out a book I thought you might enjoy. It's a short read, so it should keep your attention even if you don't usually read. And we could, you know, discuss it if you wanted. This is... How is this girl accidentally being so cute? Oops. She even picked out a book she thinks I like, despite me not reading much. Yuri, thank you. I'll definitely read this. Enthusiastically, take the book. Few, well, you can read it at your own pace. Ich überfliege es gerade ein bisschen zu schnell, Entschuldigung. I look forward to hearing what you think. Now that everyone settled in, I expect Monika to kick off some scheduled activities for the club.
Ist jetzt wieder gerade?
Fucking. But that doesn't seem to be the case. Yuri's face is already buried in a book. I can't help but notice her intense expression, like she was waiting for this chance. Meanwhile, Natsuki is rummaging around in the closet. Hör auf damit, Spiel! Ich kann das hören! I'm really curious to talk to Yuri a little bit more. But at the same time, I would feel bad for distracting her from reading. I catch a glimpse of the cover of her book. It looks like the same book that she lent to me. More than that, she seems to be on the first few pages. Crap. I think she noticed me looking at her. She sneaks another glance at me and our eyes meet for a split second. Das ist auch anders, oder? Als beim letzten Mal. But that only makes her hide her face deeper in her book. Sorry. I was just spacing out. I muttered as sensing I made her uncomfortable. Oh, it's fine. If I was focused, then I probably wouldn't have noticed in the first place. But I'm just rereading a bit of this, so... That's the book you gave me, right? Mm-hmm. I wanted to reread some of it. Not for any particular reason. Just curious how come you have two copies of the same book. Well, when I stopped at the bookstore yesterday, that's not what I meant. I mean, I just happened to buy two of them.
Huh? Was?
Ah, I see. There's something fairly obvious here that Yuri isn't telling me, but I decide to let it go. Oh, definitely does you. Nein, frag da nochmal nach. Ich will das wissen. I'm glad to hear. Once it starts to pick up, you might have a hard time putting it down. It's a very engaging and relatable story.
That's so?
What's the story about anyway? Well, I look at the cover of the book. The book is entitled Portrait of Markov. There's an ominous-looking eye symbol on the front cover. Basically, it's about this religious camp that was turned into a human experiment prison. And the people trapped there have this trait that turns them into killing machines that lust for blood. But the facility gets even worse and they start selectively breeding people by cutting off their limbs and affixing them to. Oh, that might be a little bit of a spoiler.
What the fuck? Das war vorher nicht drin.
But anyway, I'm really into it. The book, I mean. Not the thing about the limbs.
That's kind of dark, isn't it?
Yuri made it sound like it was going to be a nice story, so that dark turn came from nowhere. Are you not a fan of that sort of thing, Mikey? No, it's not that. I mean, I can definitely enjoy those kinds of stories, so I don't worry.
I hope so.
Yeah, I totally forgot that Yuri is into those things. She's so shy and reclusive on the outside, but her mind seems to be completely different. It's just that this kind of story, it's the kind that challenges you to look at life from a strange new perspective. When horrible things happen, not just because someone wants to be evil, but because the world is full of horrible people and we're all worthless anyway.
Okay.
Then suddenly... I'm rambling, aren't I?
Man könnte es als rambling bezeichnen, man könnte auch sagen, du creepst die Scheiße aus mir raus.
Not again. I'm sorry.
Hey, don't apologize. I haven't lost interest or anything.
Well, es ist schön, wie wir das einfach sliden lassen, oder? So kommentarlos?
I guess it's alright then, but I feel like I should let you know that I have this problem. When I let things like books and writing fill my thoughts, my whole body get... I kind of forget to pay attention to other people.
Alter, ich hab voll Gänsehaut, man, ich komm überhaupt nicht zurecht.
So I'm sorry if I end up saying something strange and please stop me if I start talking too much.
That's... I really don't think you need to worry.
Doch. Worry. Worry a lot.
That just means you're passionate about reading.
The least I can do is listen.
It's a literature club, after all.
Ah. That's... Well, that's true. In fact, I might as well get started reading it, right?
Yes?
I mean, you don't have to, but ich sitz so auf der Stuhlkante, das glaubst du mir gar nicht, Mann.
I mean, you don't have to, but what are you saying?
Let me just get the book and quickly retrieve the book that I had put into my bag.
Alright, it's fine if I sit here, right?
I slip into the seat next to Yuri.
Ah, yeah? Are you sure?
You seem a little apprehensive.
That's... I'm sorry. It's not that I don't want you to. It's just something I'm not very used to.
That is, reading in company with someone.
I see. Well, just tell me if I end up distracting you or anything.
Hat sie nicht im ersten Durchgang noch gesagt, sie mag es, wenn man sowas gemeinsam macht?
Alright. I open the book and start the prologue. I soon understand what Yuri means about reading in company. It's as if I can feel her presence over my shoulders if I read. It's not particularly a bad thing. Maybe a little distracting, but the feeling is somewhat comforting.
Hatten wir das vorher nicht mit Natsuki?
Yuri is in the corner of my eye. I realize that she's not actually looking at her own book. I glance over. It looks like she's reading from my book instead.
Sorry.
I was just bathing in the feeling... Yuri, you really apologize a lot, don't you?
I do? I don't really mean to.
Sorry. Fuck, ich komm grad immer auf die rechte Maustaste. Dann verschwindet das Sexfenster aus irgendeinem Grund.
I mean...
Here, this should work, right?
I slide my desk until it's up against Yuri's, then hold my book more between the two of them.
Ah. I suppose so. Yuri timidly closes her own copy. Once we each other lean in a little bit, our shoulders are almost touching. It feels like my left arm is in the way, so instead I use my right hand to hold the book open. I guess that makes it kind of difficult to turn the page.
Here.
Yuri takes her left arm and holds the left side of the book between her thumb and forefinger.
Ah, I do the same with my right arm on the right side of the book.
That way I turn a page and Yuri slides it under her thumb after it flips to her page. But in holding like this... We're huddled even closer together than before.
It's actually kind of distracting me.
It's as if I can feel the warmth of Yuri's face and she's in the corner of my vision.
Are you ready?
Hmm?
To turn the page.
Ah, sorry.
Ich muss hier so ein bisschen in dieses seltsame Anime-Denken reingehen, das ich absolut nicht drauf habe. Aber kann es sein, dass Yuri hier dafür verantwortlich ist? Dass sie mehr Aufmerksamkeit von mir haben wollte und dann eben diesen Loop gestartet hat, weil ich vorhin mit Sayuri angebändelt habe und dass er sie deswegen aus dem Weg geräumt hat.
Oder interpretiere ich da zu viel rein? In das hier jetzt.
I think I got a bit distracted for a second. I glance over at Yuri's face again and our eyes meet. I don't know how I'll be able to keep up with her. Ich hab's die ganze Zeit im Hinterkopf, deswegen vergesse ich auch manchmal gerade vorzulesen. Dann bin ich derjenige, der outspaced.
I'm not as used to reading, right?
I don't mind being patient if it takes you a bit longer. It's probably the least I can do. Since you've been so patient with me.
Creepy.
Thanks. We continue reading. Yuri no longer asks me if I'm ready to turn the page. Instead, I just assume that she finishes the page before me, so I turn it a bit by my own volition. We continue the first chapter in silence. Even so, turning each page almost feels like an intimate exchange. My thumb gently letting go of the page, letting it flutter over to her side as she catches it under her own thumb.
Hey, Yuri.
This might be a silly thought, but the main character kind of reminds me of you a little bit.
Huh?
No, I don't relate to this character at all.
Definitely not.
Really? I was just thinking the way she second guesses things she says and all that.
That's why you were talking. What you're talking about? Sorry.
I thought you meant something else about her.
Something else?
Never mind. We didn't even get that far yet. So I don't know why that came into my head.
Yuri, are you feeling alright?
Huh? Yuri's been a little fidgety ever since we started reading. You can rest if you're feeling sick or something. Your breathing is a little...
My breathing?
Yuri puts a hand on her chest as if to feel her heartbeat.
I didn't even notice.
Anyway, I'm fine. I just need some water.
Alright, don't push yourself.